Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to the another video on Room. In this video, we are going to have a look at how to set up Room database, which is the final step of the Room database setup. But before we do that, let's have a quick recap of what we have done so far. We created an entity. So entity is basically a class which defines the structure of the table that we are going to create in the SQLite database. And then to support the proper data conversion from either JSON to SQLite or from SQLite database to the Kotlin objects, we have created the converters. Once again, you create the converter by adding the converter annotation and then writing the logic to how to convert from JSON to a Kotlin object and from Kotlin object back to a data which is convenient for storing it in the database. And if you recall correctly, in the previous video, we created the data access object. Data access object is basically the class which contains the stub code which defines the database operations, which are basically the CRUD operations. So now we are all set for creating the database. So let's get into the discussion of the AppDatabase class. And as has been the case so far, here we use the annotation for the creation of the database class. The annotation here is the @database. This basically marks the class as a room database. But then just marking a class with database annotation is not good enough. We need to also configure it with lot of other things like data access object, entity, converters, the things that we have created so far. So let's have a look at how this looks like. To get started, you create a abstract class and then you ensure that that abstract class extends room database. Then you add database annotation to basically mark the class as room database. To that annotation, you can pass any number of entity classes that you want to add in that particular database. You can see that here we are passing an entity called country class. This entity denotes the table that will get created in the underlying SQLite database. Then you also have to provide the converters. It is basically the class that you might have created to handle the data transformation logic. You also pass the DB version. This is an integer number. You typically get started with 1, and then if the next version of the app push, the data structure changes, it could be like adding a new table or adding a new column to an existing database, then you upgrade this version. This helps the room library to handle this database structure change in a graceful manner as you go through multiple pushes of the app. There are more details that we need to cover. Enough of theory, time to do some hands-on now. So let's get into a demo. So what we will do is, in this database package, we will create another Kotlin class and we will call that as AppDatabase. And this needs to be a abstract class and it should extend room database. Import the room database. And as I had told earlier, you will have to use the database annotation and then entities. You have to pass the entities denoting the various tables that you want to add into this particular database. In this case, we have only one, that is country, and then the version, which is 1 to get started with. And then you have to pass the type converters. And in this case, you have to give the class which has the converters. So in our case, it is converters class. So the basic setup is ready, but then the actual implementation starts. Inside, we will have to create a function which returns a data access object. In our case, it is country DAO. So what we will do is abstract function country DAO, and that function returns country DAO. The code gets generated for this by the annotation processor when we build our application. The next part is to implement a thread-safe singleton pattern, which returns me the instance of this app database that contains the DAO object. The DAO object is our single point of entry for all the database operations, because that is where we have basically defined all our CRUD operations. And we want to ensure that when the database gets created, only one instance of the database gets created. And for that, we need to follow a singleton design pattern. We will create the companion object, and then we will create a private instance of app database. Private var instance of app database. It can be null as well. And then typically the best practice is to mark it with the annotation called as volatile. Why do we use it? Well, you have to remember that this database will be used by the application to maintain its data. And there might be multiple threads running in your application, which might be trying to fetch the data, update the data. So you want to ensure that these threads don't cache the data. And this happens in a thread-safe manner. To do that, we have to use volatile annotation. So now we have the app database, but it is not yet initialized. The instance is not yet initialized. So what do we do? Once again, we will write a function. Function get database, and it takes the context and returns app database. And then inside return, check whether instance is null. If it is null, then initialize it. But once again, do it in a thread-safe manner. What do I mean by thread-safe manner? Once a thread comes inside this code block and tries to initialize this app database instance, no other thread should be allowed to enter inside this code block. So in a way, you are trying to ensure that only one thread enters this code block, and once it enters and creates the instance of the database, no other thread should try to enter. So we are trying to basically implement a thread-safe singleton design pattern. So to do that, we will use synchronized block, this, and inside this, we will create a instance of room.database builder, and this takes context.application context, and then the app database itself, and then the name of the database. In this case, you can call it as country database. This instance can now be initialized to the companion object that has instance, and then you can return the instance. So we are almost done. So now we have basically implemented the entity, DAO, converters, and finally configured the app database. But we cannot directly start using this in the composable. There is actually a proper way to do it. You will have to implement something called as repository design pattern, and then use that repository in the view model, and then from the view model, you use it in the composable. So even though we have created a basic structure of the room database, it is not yet usable. In the next upcoming videos, we will actually see how to consume this in a proper way so that it actually works. So stay tuned. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.